Warm welcome to Pastor Matthew Cummings.
You've been very patient. Thank you, Matthew. You don't have to put on that coat. It's hot in here.
It's cold now.
All right.
Thank you. So, I was noticing in your laws here, I'm dealing with a bunch of fellow, I'm a right-wing extremist. Now, you guys, I know we're not in church, but I need a little bit more enthusiasm. What you're getting there is a small little pamphlet. It says, Matthew Cummings, in regard to my own view of Diane Oughton. Now, who is Diane Oughton? Diane Oughton was my preschool teacher. She also was very much involved with SDS, Students for a Democratic Society. She was the original lover of William Ayers. Hello. I got your attention on that one. Hello. Also, in regard to that, please, I tried to bring about 110 of those. That's my own personal words. Now remember, this is from a memory of when I was 7 years old. So originally, where am I from? I'm originally from Ann Arbor, Michigan. I'm a Michigan Wolverine fan originally. Now, since I'm in Oregon territory, I better say I'm a repented Michigan Wolverine fan. Okay? In 1968, some people came to my mother. My mom's name is Doris Patterson, and talked to her about a very well up and coming grad student at the University of Michigan who was going to revolutionize education. And that the request to my mother was to put me in an open school. That open school, probably most of you have heard of it, it's called Children's Community School. My mom thought about it, and after a conversation which my mom had with Diane Oughton, who was one of my mom's best friends, my mom decided to put me in this school. The first day of school, our principal was none other than William Ayers. He walked in, said what he felt he needed to say, put his hand on my head. Of all the students, I was the only Afro-American student that was there. After he left, Diane Oughton said this to me and to all the other students: you no longer have to listen to your parents. You no longer have to listen to anyone of authority. We're now your authority. Now, remember, I'm a 7-year-old rambunctious little boy. So the moment Diane Oughton made that comment, I was happy as ever. Because I was going to get to go home and challenge my mother about all the things that she told me to do. So I got home. Trust me, it was like it was yesterday. And by the way, yeah, that's me. By the way, my mom always reminds me, I brought you in the world. I can take you out of the world. Ladies, does that sound familiar? So I walked in, having received this wonderful revelation from from the new school, and basically walked up to my mother and said, Mom, I've been informed today from my teacher, Diane Oughton, that I no longer have to listen to you. Now, from the time that last word left my mouth to the facial expression on my mom's face, I knew I had lost. But, Patriots, I want to tell you something. My mom did something very smart. She said, wait right here. Now, you know I was thinking the belt was coming, hello? But she said, wait. And she grabbed a pen, and she grabbed some paper, and she said, what else did Diane tell you? And every day for 2 months, she pumped me for information. And she wrote it down. And then she contacted other parents and asked them, what are your children telling you? Because Diane is telling me that my kid no longer has to listen to me. And so after 2 months, and my mom being the kind of black woman that she would be, I said that for a reason, Sister Esther. Walked on in to the school while Diane was teaching and went off on Diane. I remembered watching. It's the only time I could smile and get away with it. My mother went off for 45 minutes. Because you see, Diane had betrayed her. She betrayed a trust. It was not too long after that SDS split. It was not too long after that Diane Oughton and William Ayers split. And Diane Oughton, the reason why I find her more important than William Ayers is because Diane Oughton really became one of the major bomb makers for the Weatherman Underground. Hello?
Wow.
She oversaw the making of the bombs with several other people, but she was the main instrument to see that bombs were made to bomb federal installations in Chicago, in Philadelphia, in New York. And unfortunately, and I say this unfortunately, because Diane Oughton herself had a legitimate teaching gift. Patriots, she was deceived. See, that's what happens when you get involved with communism.
Yeah.
Hello?
Yeah, hi.
That's what happens when you get involved with socialism. Mm-hmm. You get brainwashed. Uh-huh. Common sense goes out the door. Mm-hmm. Wait a minute. Did you just tell a preacher that I had 20 minutes?
Did you?
I mean, just be getting the Holy Ghost. Now, come on. I'm teasing. Trying to lighten the load. About a year and a half ago, I asked my mom some questions because for so many years, my mom has been afraid to actually speak on this subject that I'm speaking now. When I wrote these little 7 pages, you know what my mom realized? I had remembered more than she thought. To this day, my mom is still afraid to a point of William Ayers and others because of how effective they have done to our education system.
Yeah, no kidding.
See, William Ayers has his tenure at the University of Illinois in Chicago. Children's Community School laid the foundation for helping to dummy down our children.
Yeah.
Hello?
Uh-huh.
It helped to lay the foundation. Well, Diane Oughton was doing the school. William Ayers was preaching the gospel of left-wing politics to every school across the country. And then when he became the head of the Weatherman Underground, and I, you know, a lot of you got a lot of information. I kind of lived a little bit of that information, for real.
Yeah.
So for me, it's personal. Mm-hmm. And because it's personal, I want to say this to every patriot here. If you don't make sure that this next election, you don't take it personal to get rid of this socialist, communist person, mm-hmm. you need to take it personal. Now, I'm going to say this because time is short and they still realize that they've given a preacher 20 minutes. Your local politics is so important right now. So many of the people that are in your city councils, your commissions, they're progressives, they're to the left. Mm-hmm. They were part of SDS. Hello? So many of your school board people are fully socialists. You know what? It's literally going to take, if we're honest, patriots, 6 to 7 election cycles to get rid of all of the socialist and Marxist people that are in every aspect of our government. Uh-huh. See, for me, what do I have to lose anymore? I've preached against this president for almost 4 years.
All right, thank you.
I started before he was president, so I got in trouble beforehand. I came back from Europe preaching against Barack Obama.
All right.
And it was the second time ever that my family said, the white sheep of the family. Sorry, can't be black sheep. I've had arguments with wonderful, wonderful deceived liberals. And we'll get into a discussion of our president. And these liberals happen to be Caucasian. And we're going back and forth. And they'll get so caught up in the moment. And they'll say, you're a racist! And I'll look at my watch. I'll give them about 20 seconds to think about what they just said and who they're arguing with. Hello?
Yeah, hello.
You have neighbors and friends and family members who right now know that our country's going the wrong way, but they're afraid of being called a racist. Uh-huh. The time to be afraid of that is over.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Please, please help me get rid. You guys, I did not celebrate at the inaugural. I cried. I'm serious.
Yeah, same here.
I knew exactly the direction we were going.
Yes.
Yeah.
No.
I did not celebrate.
Uh-huh.
So for me, it's been personal.
Uh-huh.
Because anyone who gets support from William Ayers, I know exactly where they're from.
Yes.
Anyone who William Ayers supports, they're fully to the left.
Mm-hmm.
He never supports a person of common sense. Mm-hmm. He never supports a patriot. Hello?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I'm almost done. I'm not a politician. I've been doing real good not to quote scripture.
You can quote one.
Oh, no, we're not big. You have a First Amendment.
I know that, but I've been doing real good on that. I've spoken at many other things, and I've gone there, and afterwards there's been all kind of firestorm, and I walk away smiling, but everyone else is upset.
Their problem.
But that's not my interest here. My interest is that each and every one of you multiplies times 10 in this region.
Mm-hmm.
Hello?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Each and every one of you multiplies times 20 in this region.
Mm-hmm.
Can you imagine the president loses Oregon?
Yeah. Uh-huh. Yeah. Uh-huh.
Can you dare to imagine it?
Yes.
I know it's going to happen. That's why you're here for such a time as this.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. That's right.
Uh-huh.
So if there's anything religious I will say, and I'm not trying to offend anyone, but I'm going to go there. You need fire to get under your blessed assurances. Like never before.
Uh-huh.
This is going to be the worst fight that's ever come.
Uh-huh.
Because it's going to get nastier before the end. Trust me.
Or it's over.
Or it's over, yeah.
I'm trying not to go there.
Go there. I've got two more minutes. No. Okay. Can Matthew preach and can Matthew spend a few more minutes?
Yeah.
Okay. Is that okay?
No, that's okay. I'm good with the time.
We are. Come on, preach it, brother.
Well, I don't know. It's starting to sound hot in here. Look, I started talking about socialism in the churches that I was visiting. Some all black, some mixed, some majority Caucasian. And for every one believer who actually understood me, five others, it was going over their head.
Wow. Yeah.
You have to understand that.
Wow.
When you're saying socialism to people, it's going over a lot of the people's heads.
Uh-huh.
Because they do not realize that they're fully entrenched in it. So you literally have to break them out of the mold.
Mm-hmm.
And so that's what I do when I go to churches. We do an evening where we literally go to a second or third or fourth grade level of what socialism is, what communism is. And then from there, I've seen nothing but good fruit. I've seen pastors and their wives and others who were not involved in the political process get involved immediately.
Whoa, that's what we need.
Wow.
I've seen it all over the country.
Wow.
But I've seen something else too. I've seen many shepherds afraid to touch the subject.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh.
For fear of retribution.
Uh-huh.
I've had pastors call me in and say, what happens if Obama wins in November? And I'll say, well, then I guess you won't be a 501(c)(3), will you?
Uh-huh. Yeah, big deal.
You see, some of you laughed, others of you were real quiet. You know why? Because the idea of him winning is scary, isn't it?
Oh, yeah.
I didn't hear you.
Yes.
Okay. Now, this isn't a black church, bro. You're ready to go there now.
To preach it, yeah.
When I look in the back, every man and woman, I see a person who could turn this county, this state, this nation upside down with your voice alone. Hello?
Amen.
Never again should we as conservatives be overwhelmed that we would shut up when an aggressive progressive person comes towards us.
Mm-hmm. Bullies.
See, that's the only thing the left has, is to basically scare you out of your principles. Mm-hmm. That's all they have. Mm-hmm. They don't have the truth on their side.
Right.
So all they can do is see to it that at the end of the day, you are afraid for your life.
Yeah.
Well, that's not enough anymore. Our founding fathers faced it already.
Yeah.
And they swore everything unto the end. That spirit must come upon him. Help me, Lord, because I almost started preaching. Let me stop.
Preach it.
It is a necessity right now, patriots, that each and every one of you realize, get it in your spirit now. This election is a personal affront to you.
Yes.
As well it is to me.
Mm-hmm. And to our children.
Go ahead.
To our children's, to our grandchildren's, to our great-grandchildren.
Mm-hmm. Yes, yes, yes.
I haven't just started. You know I've been doing this for a long time. Mm-hmm. And I've offended a lot of people and loved it.
Yeah.
The problem is that when you offend, what's really happening is that a person hears what you say, they don't like it, they get angry. Uh-huh. And then the problem is that you don't have a person coming behind to speak the truth in love afterwards, to bring that person around to what truth really is. Uh-huh. Truth is that smaller government is the only way that America will last.
Yes.
Come on.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Truth is that the natural law tells us that if our founding fathers indeed wrote the Constitution, then we must preserve the Constitution by any means necessary.
That's right.
Okay, I guess I'm in trouble now. You got it recorded.
Are we healed?
Uh-oh.
Truth is, it's worth enough for my life now. That's where I've come to now. I do know what happens if we do not win.
Uh-huh.
I saw it back in 1969. I saw a teacher that I actually liked. A teacher that actually liked me. Even when my mother pulled me out of school. Let me tell you something. Diane Oughton, every 2 weeks before she went to her death, came over to my mother and I's house and asked how I was doing. Hello? So the issue was that William Ayers, who's not repented from anything he's done, mm-hmm. who says he wished he could have done more.
Whoa.
What?
Well, yeah, yeah, exactly.
Has seemed to escape the judgment, but he will not. A day will come when he'll be dealt with by God.
Yeah. Yes. Amen.
One last thing. No, I couldn't preach today. I have to be good.
You can conclude, though.
I'm going to, right? Can I have everyone stand up, please? I am looking with optimism at a country which will never go left again, right here.
Yes.
Yeah. Wow, you said it. That's
hello?
It. Yes.
It's that important to me that we never again elect a socialist, Marxist president again. So would you please repeat after me? I, an extreme right extremist,
extreme right extremist.
Vow.
Vow
to educate.
To educate.
Here in Oregon.
Here in Oregon.
My neighbors.
My neighbors.
My family members.
My family members.
My pastors.
My pastors.
That the time has come.
That the time has come.
To take a righteous stand.
To take a righteous stand.
To defeat this president.
To defeat this president.
And stand on the principles.
And stand on the principles.
That our forefathers stood on.
That our forefathers stood on.
And that our kids will stand on.
And that our kids will stand on.
That our grandkids will stand on.
That our grandkids will stand on.
That our great grandkids will stand on.
That our great grandkids will stand on.
Thank you. Amen.
That is, a lot of people here represent different congregations, faiths, you know, synagogues, parishes, and I'd like to know if I knew you wanted to just go have the reins cut off and preach. I know, and I'm grateful for you for that. And I want to have an opportunity for anybody who can invite you to their church to once again give your contact information so that they can invite you. And it's a one flight round trip from Lincoln, Nebraska. Maybe you can have an itinerary and work it out with the people who. So could you give your contact information one more time? And Herb, could you put it back on the screen?
Yeah. Okay. Now I am what they call a traveling minister, so. I'll let you know, starting in September and October, I'll be here for about 2 months ministering in the region.
Thank you.
Wow, that's great.
So if there is any interest, the contact information is given to you. I literally do an hour evening on socialism and communism and why it's the worst threat to our country. So if you know of anyone that's interested in that specifically, I focus on the church, on people of faith, and I'll tell you why. 95% of the black church voted for Barack Obama. 65 to 75% of the Catholic Church voted for Barack Obama. 65 to 75% of the evangelical church voted for Barack Obama.
Wow.
I'm sorry, it was not the youth that put him in.
Uh-huh.
It was a very ill-informed church.
Uh-huh.
That was the majority of him getting in.
Uh-huh.
And as God is my witness, and I'm only saying this once, and you got it recorded so I can never get away from it. As God is my witness, it should never again be that the church votes for a socialist or communist in this country. That is the rest of my life, to educate God's people what time it is. I'll let it go.
So your contact information, the best way to get a hold of you?
Yeah.
Did everybody get a business card?
It's up there.
Okay.
It's up there.
Okay, great. And then one last question. If people would like to, you flew over just for our meeting, as far as I know. It was an airfare. Did you come with anybody else?
No, just me.
Okay, well, there's still probably $400 or $500 airfare. Can people help out with like a ministry?
Well, sure.
Ministry? So how do they help
sure.
out?
What you do is that you write Matt Cummings Ministry.
All right. Rule of
yeah, go
hat.
Ahead.
Okay. Can we borrow your hat, sir? Okay. Can we borrow your hat? We need to pass a hat
for
Pastor Cummings. Thank you, thank you.
Right, check or cash.
Okay.
He says check or cash.
Okay.
And thank everyone here. Thank you, Pastor Cummings. Just give him, are we done? Give him a big round of applause. Thank you for gratitude. Thank you very much. And Sarah, anything else that anybody has for the good of the order before we adjourn?
Oh,
anybody here that we didn't cover something that we should have covered?
Well, just thank you so much for braving this nasty traffic out here on Friday afternoon. God bless you, love you, and take some food home with you too. We don't want to bring that, so feel free. Let's all say to help Pastor Cummings and. Hey, Pastor Matthew, are you a 501c3?
Yes.
So oh, you are? Oh, okay. Well, okay. If you weren't, I would give to you probably more, because I believe in your message. No gag rule.
So you get a benefit, a tax deductible gift. Roxanne.
Does he have any appointments yet in Portland?
Portland appointments, when? Any month? October, September, any place?
Yeah.
So this itinerary is free, so move quickly.
Okay.
Before it fills up.
Yeah, I spoke with
anybody else before we adjourn?